you're gonna find some people to live. You don't have to worry, cause you have no money. People on the river are happy to give. Big wheel keep on turning. A primary keep on burning. We're rolling good, rolling good, rolling on the river. Rolling, rolling, rolling on the river. Rolling, rolling, rolling on the river.
You are watching Johnny Cash Presents the Everly Brothers Show with tonight's guest, the Statler Brothers, Evie Sands, Fred Smoot, and special guest Neil Diamond.
I'm Don Everly.
And I'm Phil Everly.
And together we're the Everly Brothers.
I've noticed that.
Yes, and before the show, these nice people were asking a few questions, and so...
Yeah, they didn't really nail us on them, so if they've got it, we're going to give you another chance to answer, ask us some questions, and we'll try to answer them. If anybody has a question, now...
Raise your hand, or stand up, or there's one right there, I think.
Do you have any animal pets?
Yeah.
He has me.
Yeah. He's not housebroken, though.
No. Anymore?
Keep telling
me. I'm not sure I want to hear it anymore. Yes, ma'am.
Do you ever record songs in a foreign language?
Did we ever record songs in foreign language? Not
I'm
too
well. Off Delida. I'm
needless to say, it flopped.
It was terrible.
It went kaput.
There's a question there.
Yeah, this is for Phil. Where did you get your vest from? I like that.
Wardrobe.
Most productive musical talents. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Neil Diamond.
Do a man Bojangles and he'd dance for you. Baggy pants, the old soft shoe. And he jumped so high, jumped so high, and it lightly touched down. The Lord. Hey, Mr. Bojangles, come on, dance.
Somewhere. Where are you? I know you're in here.
What are you talking about?
There he is. I get him. Okay, Mac, out of here. You hear me?
Hey, what are you doing talking to our audience like
Come on,
that?
Listen, son, it's my duty as the ABC parking guard to protect this lot out here, and this nobody has parked in the executive lot.
Come here.
Hey, come on, get your hands off me. Y'all can get in serious trouble assaulting an ABC parking guard.
Listen, you just can't barge in here and treat a member of our audience that way. That's an insult.
An insult? What do y'all call it when you sing to him?
Sergeant Higgins. You're making a big thing out of nothing.
Listen, boys, don't you tell me how to run my pocket out here. I don't tell you how to do that get up little Susie.
Yeah? That's wake up little Susie. Yeah.
Well, it don't make no difference to me. It all sounds the same when it's that narcotic music.
Listen, Guard Higgins, it's after working hours. All the executives are gone. Why don't you just kind of look the other way?
Now, I would look the other way if this was something insignificant. We're talking about the parking lot.
Oh, you're being impossible.
It's ridiculous to talk about this anymore. I'll tell you what, let it go this time, and if you get any static, we'll take full responsibility. We'll put our jobs right on the line. That's right.
Put your jobs on the line? Want a couple of weeks, you two summer replacement boys going to be out there and back singing at rodeos anyway.
Look, you're embarrassing us again.
Listen, I'm only the parking guard here. You boys are embarrassed. You better talk to your costume designer.
Well, we're going to have someone speak to you about the way you've been talking to people around here. We certainly are going to do that.
Don't you threaten me, boy. It would behoove you to remember that I got a lot of pull in Hollywood. Okay, I'll fix it so you all can't park in this town anywhere again. All right, Mac, I've had enough of this. Y'all come on out of here now, yeah? You got your automobile parked in the executive lot. That's violation 52-12 of the ABC parking code.
Well, I'm terribly sorry. I just thought it was okay to park in there.
Well, it ain't.
Since I'm the new ABC vice president of affiliate programming.
Say what?
Since I'm just transferred out from New York, I'm not too clear on the parking rules. Maybe if you'll stop by my office at 9:30 tomorrow morning, you could clarify what I did wrong.
Well, I just tell you, I just thought I'd stop by and get
away.
Come
on, Joe, if you're going to yank him out of here, hurry up.
You don't have to worry about it.
Joe,
you
do your
duty.
Do your duty, Joe. Come on.
Cut it out.
You're going to yank him out or not?
I don't think we got to do anything about this. I don't see no reason to get together in the morning.
Hey, Joe,
I tell you what, we'll just let it go this time.
Do your duty.
You're going with your show here.
Come on. What about this?
You would really call together. She's beautiful, talented, intelligent, a good cook, likes classical music, she can sew, she can clean.
Hey, wait a minute. Now, how do you know so much about her? We just met her 2 days ago.
I rehearsed longer than you did, Phil. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Evie Sands.
You don't love me.
Today there's no salvation. The band's packed up and gone. Left me standing with my penny in my hand. There's a big crowd at the station where the blind man sings his song. But he can see what they can't understand. It's the 33rd of August, and I'm finally touching down. 8 days from Sunday finds me Saturday bound. Once I stumbled through the darkness, tumbled to my knees, a thousand voices screaming in my brain. Woke up in a squad car, busted down for vagrancy, and outside my cell as sure as hell it looked like rain. It's the 33rd of August, and I'm finally touching down. 8 days from Sunday finds me Saturday bound. It's the 33rd of August, and I'm finally touching down. 8 days from Sunday finds me Saturday bound.
Rotten feeling of getting up the morning after the night before. As bad as it is for you, it couldn't possibly be as bad as it is for our next guest. Let's watch him as he reacts to himself in the mirror the morning after. Fred Smoot!
Oh, no. Oh, never again, man. I don't care. Oh, water. Oh, my hands are drowning. Oh, good morning. Shaving cream. Oh, Santa Claus, yeah. Oh, I can't waste. Oh, the nose. now. Oh, you poor easy. Oh, my God, good. Speed.
Well.
He gets with it with modern conveniences. He uses a brand new electric razor.
Now in bringing our good friends from the Johnny Cash Show,
ladies and gentlemen, the Statler Brothers.
Let me be a little kinder, let me be a little blinder to the faults of those around me. Let me praise a little more.
Georgia, wanna be back.
number Stockade. Friends have turned their back on me. Go and leave me if you wish to.
Touching warm.
Hey, Neil, the best way to catch your breath if you've lost your breath is to take two short breaths and one long breath and hold the long one. Go ahead and try it.
You serious?
Yeah.
Okay.
Two shorts and one long. Hold it.
Now, while Neil is catching his breath, we'd like to say a few words about him. He's written many fine songs. He's one of America's leading recording artists.
And Neil's concerts are famous for their excitement that they generate. Hang in there, Neil.
Right now, we'd like to do some of his hit songs with him. Have you caught your breath yet, Neil?
Thank you. Let's sing, huh?
Let's sing.
Get out of this place alive, right?
Kentucky. God will look for me. Kentucky,
part of the show where we hear stories about our relatives and ancestors from our favorite aunt, Aunt Hattie.
I'll go get her.
Okay, right. Then. You know, Aunt Hattie is the Everly family's unofficial historian. Either that or she's the all-around family gossip. We're not real sure, but we are sure that we love her. And I want you to help her make us welcome. You've been having fun out here in
London? Oh, I've just been having a wonderful time. Today, I was at a psychedelic light show at Walter Brennan's house.
That sounds like fun.
Oh, it was, until one of the guests accidentally dropped his dentures in the guacamole.
That must have been embarrassing.
Oh, it was. The poor man went through 3 bags of Fritos and never found them.
Which one of our relatives did you pick for this weekend, Hattie?
Well, this week, I'm going to tell you about your cousin Proc. You know, the one who ran away and joined the circus. He used to do fantastic things with flaming torches.
Oh, he was the fire eater?
No, he was a pyromaniac. You see, as a small boy, he was just like a moth.
You mean he was attracted to the flame?
No, he sees his clothes.
He sure must have been dedicated.
Oh, well, that's right. He loved circus life. Even when he decided to get married, he even ran away with a 700-pound woman.
Ran away?
It was a great wedding, though. He spent the entire honeymoon trying to get her over the threshold. But she was a good wife. It was because of her that he regained the 150 pounds he'd lost.
How was that?
Well, he ate her off.
Yeah, how do you know that isn't true?
Well, I know, but makes a good story. The truth is, he didn't gain any weight at all, and she got fatter and fatter. When she weighed 840 pounds, she tried to become a lion tamer, but the circus just wouldn't let her.
Why not?
Well, they couldn't afford to let out the cage.
Wait a minute. You've been putting us on.
Now, Philip, have I ever told you anything but the truth?
I don't know.
Well, let's keep it that way. Later. You know, I think I'll go today to Marineland and make faces at the shark.
Get her on the music, woo!
Imagine me and you.
I do.
I think about you day and night.
It's only right
to think about the girl you love. If I should call you up,
invest a dime,
and say that you belong to me,
and ease my mind,
how happy now the world would be.
So very fine,
so happy together.
Yeah!
We thank our friends, the Statler brothers, Evie Sands and Fred Smoot.
And our special guest star, Neil Diamond.
And we thank Ruth McDevitt and Joe Higgins.
And most of all, we thank you.
I bless the day I found you. I want to stay around you.
Top your evening off with the best in late-night television entertainment. The Dick Cavett Show. Tonight's guests include Miles Davis and James Dickey. Frank Reynolds and Howard K. Smith not only do a superb job presenting the news, but also an uncanny gift for anticipating it. Check them out weeknights on ABC.
If you must cling to someone now and forever, give peace a chance.
Thank you and good night.
Provided by the people of American Airlines. Whether you're traveling on business or traveling for fun, it's good to know you're on American Airlines.